and mentoring anointed leaders everywhere, or MAIL, a program that seeks to empower young men in the territory, was launched at the Save the Seed Energy Center, Duff's Bottom, on Saturday, February 15th. The national targeted intervention will focus on providing a positive environment for young males.
You and I know that we are losing our young men spiritually, physically, and even psychologically. Our aim, therefore, is to find answers to these troubled youth and teach them the necessary values they need to survive in this troubled environment.
Baltimore says the program is expected to help young males contend with the social decay in today's Virgin Islands society. The declining levels of essential moral values among young males in the community can be attributed to poor parenting methods and mentoring from seniors, according to the president of MAIL, Henderson Tittle. He pointed out some of the areas of focus for the MAIL program.
Our mission is to empower the young men of today to create a positive environment for tomorrow, while our vision is, with a solid foundation and the essential tools, young men will be empowered to become the future leaders of today and tomorrow. Why focus on MAIL? And what are we focusing on? Spiritual growth, career counseling, and career preparation, historical and culture cultivation, importance of community service, the emphasis on demonstration and demonstrating the role of a man in the society, health and hygiene enhancement, academic. These are some of the things that as MAIL, we want to focus on.
Keynote speaker Dr. Drexel Glasgow turned the spotlight on the seeming appetite for negativity within the society that some seem to delight in the demise of other persons.
I have noticed as a human being that somehow it seems that maybe because of our orientation that we thrive on negative publicity. Yes, we do. Negative publicity. We love the juice. We love melee, as we will call it. We often capitalize on the misfortunes of others. For some unorthodox reason, we get excited when people get into trouble. Can you imagine that? When people get in trouble, we get excited. I know you are saying, what is he talking about? Not me. Well, let me bring it a little closer to home. Have you ever seen a public fight without a big commotion of either innocent bystanders, looking news, or friends egging on, and whoever will throw the most blows? And what's so amazing, it does not matter if either of the persons are our friends. We support who is throwing the most blows. And get this, oftentimes your friend is eating licks, but you never attempt to part the fight. Okay, I take it. I must admit that it may be a little bit of a different dynamics if you try to part the fight, because you yourself might get beat up. And especially with the social media age, we often see onlookers taking pictures, taking videos, simply to post it on Instagram or Facebook. Of course, this is only one example, but it is almost automatic. We as a people tend to gravitate to headlines that are negative in nature. The breaking news of our media houses almost always relate to a negative story.
Attention was drawn on the shift in the gender balance that allows equal opportunities for males and females by 3rd District Representative Julian Fraser. He spoke of the competitive nature of today's society and urged the young men to prepare themselves to assume leadership roles.
But boys, the world has changed. The gender bias that I was talking about was that society made preparations for you to catch up. They stereotype the various positions that women would take in life, and they held them the ones that women couldn't get for you when you made it to maturity. Those days are over. The days when the decks were stacked against women are over. There used to be a glass ceiling for women. That ceiling has been crashed. So you now have to start early, work hard, and listen to your mentors in order to succeed and make it to become a leader in society. You cannot do the things that I have done and be where I am today. Those days are over.
Deputy Premier Dr. Kedric Pickering was also in attendance and expressed his support for the MALE program. MALE has already attracted over 70 mentees and close to 30 mentors. The various activities would be held at locations around the territory.